Hello, welcome to 9design 3D. In this video, we will make basic type head and face retopo. As you remember, in the previous video, we made how to sculpt head. I showed them before. You can go from the top right card and check this video if you want to learn how to sculpt a head as a stylized character. And after that, as a continuous of that video, we will make this retopo in here. Let's go to the video. First, we will hide with the edge, our hairs and lights. And now, in the solid view, let's start retopo. For the retopo, first we will add a plane to our scene with Shift A. And after that, rotate it and x-axis 19 degree. Scale and place above your lip. We will use all this process in edit mode. Don't forget to activate this snap, face project and select this species from here. And in object mode, we will add a shrink wrap modifier as a target, choose your character head. When you press tab to edit mode, as you see it looks weird, don't forget to check this on cage on the shrink wrap modifier. Now, with the moving your vertices, you can place them. But before all of that, go to object properties, under the viewport display, we will choose this in front. Now we can see all the things clearly. And go to Edit, Preferences, Add-ons and type F2. We will use this add-on for making something easily. Now, we will add a mirror modifier in object mode. You can choose your head again as a mirror object and don't forget to check your clipping. With the moving your vertices, they will snap together. Let's start our process with easily. Choose your side of the vertices or with the keyboard too, you can set up it with the edge mode. I will use this vertex mode. I will choose them and E to extrude. We will give a round shape around our lips. For the nose part, you can shift it to duplicate this face. And with the keyboard 1 again, turn back to the vertex mode. Choose side vertices and E to extrude them. We will give a round shape around our cheek and chin. For the top of it, choose this vertex again, E to extrude. And for these two vertices, press M and merge them at center, they will stick together. As the other method, you can choose this side vertex and press F to create new face. For your topology, we will use this method too in somewhere. And around the eyes, we will continue to E to extrude around the shape, look like a mask, and snap them together. It looks a bit weird. Go to Show Overlays menu and under of it, under the shading, you can choose the retopology. Now you can see all the clearly with different color. It will be easier of your retopology process. If you want, you can hide it again from there. For the adding extra loop cut, you can use Ctrl R. You can choose your edge lines and press G twice for slide them. Choose these bottom edges and E to extrude them. From the sides, we will give a round shape around our nose. For the side of it, we will extrude extra face in here from two and stick them together. After that, we will use this F2 method, choose a side vertex and F to fill. If they are stick together, you can uncheck your clipping for a while. Move and tidy up your vertices. After that, you can activate your clipping again. For the side, I am choosing a vertex and pressing F. For the nose hole, I am choosing a vertex and F again for making a new face in here. You can continue to make a topology around the nose and nostrils and merge at center some of the vertices. Under the nose, you can E to extrude, add extra loop cut and F to fill for giving extra shape. And now, I will activate retopo again. With the pressing F, to the side vertices. If they are too much geometry around it, you can choose your edge line, press X and dissolve edge. We have to take care of, we don't want to. Triangles, we will work with the quads for making our unwrap process and texture bean. So, I'm making full of quads. Choose this inner edge line with Alt, E to extrude, right click and S to scale. Move your vertices again in the nostrils. Choose them again. As you see from the statics, we have 8 vertices. Now, E to extrude, right click and S to scale again. Make this edge line closer and Ctrl F. Press grid fill and it will make quads topple into the nostril. For the upper lip, we will add a Ctrl R with loop cut again and choose this 4 vertex F to fill. Choose side vertices and continue to press F. For the side of the cheeks and lips, you can F to fill this geometry in here. If you don't have enough geometry, you can add loop cut or you can dissolve some edges from the side. As you see, there is a triangle. We don't want it. You can dissolve some edges in here. We see now a quad in there. You can choose side vertices and F to fill. For the up part of it, we will make same thing, but we need 3 loop cut in here. You can choose the side vertices and continue to fill. I will speed up this moving my vertices and tied up parts. I am adding extra loop cut again. Choose these 2 edge line, E to extrude them behind the ear. For the bottom part, press F and continue to make retopo. As you see, it looks a bit weird. We have to change it. Under the retopology, it looks inside of the cheek. For this, press on cage on the shrink wrap and it will tidy up your process. For the side of the upper cheek, you can continue to press F. For the side, give extra faces with choosing your side vertex and pressing F. I will turn back to open my retopology under the overlays. For the inner of eye, you can choose this E to extrude, right click and S to scale. As I said before, we will make a mask type round shape around our eyes. For bottom of the eyelids, you can E to extrude these faces. You can give extrusion some separated parts. It will be make easier process. I'm choosing this and merge at center the side vertices. And continue to pressing F, but give around the shape inner of the eyelid this type of. You can choose this 4 vertex and F to fill. Add extra loop cut, inner of eyelid, merge at center the side vertices, and continue to give some faces. Make this upper nose shape like this. I am adding extra loop cut between the eyes. I will choose this chin type and E to extrude back of the head. Under the chin, you can choose this edge line and E to extrude down to the back. Fill up your faces from there. For the upper of the head, you can think about is a box and E to extrude this vertex. And after that, choose these 2 vertices and right click subdivide. After you subdivide, take care of the between this vertex line and the other part has the equal vertices. I am making same thing with extruding my 1 vertex. For the back, I am making same thing. If you don't have enough geometry, you can add extra loop cuts in here too. For the top of it, I will subdivide them again. And I will give extra faces and geometry in there. For top of it, E to extrude these top vertices, add extra loop cuts, give a quad shape again, continue to F to fill your top side vertices. upper of the ear, I will have to fill this two-line vertex, subdivide again, make same process for getting some quads. For back of it, you can subdivide it again. Take care of the equal vertices has your line and geometry. You can choose some of your vertices, right click and smooth your vertices. For the back of it, I am making same process all my head. For the back, you can have to fill. I made before some characters retopo process with the time-lapse video. If you want, you can go from the top right card and watch this other my sculpting character videos. I am making retopo in there too. Inner of eyelid, you can choose this edge line, E to extrude, right click and S to scale. And tied up your inner eyes of the vertices. We will leave it like that for now. For inner of your lips, you can choose this vertex line, E to extrude, right click and S to scale, and after that move and tidy up your lip vertices. If you want, you can add some throat teeth, but I will leave it like that for now. Inner of the lips, you can add extra loop cut with Ctrl R. After it's done, let's make our ear. For the ear, we will use again same the quad shape. I will add an extra loop cut for the head to the side. Choose top of the ear's vertices, E to extrude them like this. Again, E to extrude. We will give some 2 or 3 extrusion for cover up our ear. You can add extra loop cut inner of them. And choose your connection part of the head and ear. You can press F and add new faces and geometry around the ear. We will make round the shape again. Ear can be a bit hard, but if you follow this process, it can be easier maybe for you. I am moving these top vertices. I will choose these 2 vertex and merge them at center. You can E to extrude these sides. As the same process, I am tidying up my vertices, pressing F to adding new face and geometry around the ear. After you round the shape done around the ear, you can choose this inner vertices for 2 edge, E to extrude and scale for inner of the ear. For the top of it, you can E to extrude these vertices to the down and continue to make round the shape inner of the ear. We want some quads in there too. Add the fill and merge at center some of the vertices. For the inner of the ear, you can choose an edge line and E to extrude to the down. I recommend you can extrude some part of it with the separately, and after that you can fill with the F and the geometry inner of your ear. You can control all the vertices and all the faces quickly and easily. I am continuing to adding my extra faces. Merge them at center. Some of the vertices again, giving a round shape. And for the side, when you choose a vertex, again press F, give a new geometry in there, merge them at center side vertices and F to fill. Our eerie topology is ready. Now, let's make our neck part. For the back vertices, you can E to extrude them down. Under the chin area, you can E to extrude them down too. We have shrink wrap and face snap. It can be hard sometimes, so you can close this retopo type, or you can close sometimes your face snap. I'm adding extra loop cuts for the neck, an extra, choosing my vertices, and right click smooth your vertices for making smooth neck parts. For the body part or torso part, you can E to extrude this down vertices. I'm making simple retopo for the body because we are learning only head retopo in here. You can continue to E to extrude and giving some cuts for the torso part. Continue to F to fill. Merge some of vertices at center together and smooth some vertices. Our head retopo will look like this. Now, what will we do? For this, we have this low poly mesh. You can give it a name, head low. And for the female, as I said, you can type it head high. We will use them together in our modifier. Choose your low poly mesh and right click shade smooth. After that, apply your shrink wrap modifier. As you see, there is some glitch areas in here. When your mirror modifier activated, you can move some of your vertices and the x-axis with G. And tidy up your glitz. It will look like this. Choose this inner of the eyelid and E to extrude to the back. I will leave it like this. For the lips, I'm making same thing. Now you can apply your mirror modifier. Under the object data, close your in front. Hide your high poly mesh. And to the low poly mesh, we will add multi-res modifier and subdivide 3 times. And we will add a shrink wrap modifier. Choose the project as a target. Choose your head high and select negative. As you see, we have low poly mesh in here, but with the high poly details. And what will we do with this? After you apply your shrink wrap, when your multi-res modifier active, you can in the cycles bake from multi-res of your normals, it will give a normal map. You can use from the high poly to low poly. You can go from the top right card. I showed before how to transfer your old detailed data from the high poly to low poly. I am making same process in here too. You can use this method for your characters and other objects. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. See you later in new character tutorials.